We in the United States are just a group of people from somewhere else, and Tom's family is from a neighboring village here. Tom lives in our nation's capital, Washington, D.C. He was an architect for many years. He and I have a very similar background and know a lot of the same people from the same period. But the thing that you need to know about Tom today is that he is a professional painter who promotes himself through his painting. And he has a very unique style. And I was so delighted when he agreed to be part of the Fabriano USA. Would you please welcome Thomas Gucci?
Thank you. Gracias. I start everything in a sketchbook. And to me, the sketchbook has to be convenient and easy and portable to use. Otherwise, I end up not bringing it. And so I've kind of redesigned this basic Stillman and Byrne sketchbook to have a little palette inside, like that, so I can stand in front of the subject, sketch, paint. I have a little mixing area. It's basically one of those Daniel Smith dot cards that I've made out of plastic and modified so that I never hesitate to bring it with me. It's that, you know, portable. Anyway, I like to start everything with a sketch because it's a great chance to synthesize what's in front of me, simplify it, and reduce it down to what I need for a painting. So I have a photo reference here. I don't know if you can see that. I have a photo reference here.
Just put it on the towel.
But I'm really going to use the sketchbook. Is it facing the right way? But I'm going to primarily use this for my reference for the painting today. It's New York City, to those of you who don't recognize it.
Thomas?
Yes.
For those people that are out on the thing, show it like this. Just show it underneath here. If I hold it up like that, then the people out on the... There you go. The people outside can see.
Those brave.
But turn it over.
Folks,
it's a girl's head. Now show them it's New York City.
Oh, they can see it in here.
Yeah, now they can see it.
I'm just going to draw a little road map. It's not really a drawing that is meant to be seen. It's just a scheme for a painting. Something else that I just thought of that's very important in these kind of drawings is perspective. You don't have to get perspective architecturally perfect. You just have to get it so that it looks right. And there's a couple simple things you can do. You see, there's a lot of lines here that converge. And anything that's parallel, like the lines on the tiles on this floor, they vanish to a single point. So I usually try to find that point. And I'm going to say it's right about there. And every line, every window line that's parallel to that is going to converge on this point, and that's a great way to just... I oftentimes just keep my finger here as a reference point so I don't get lost when mapping this out. A bunch of windows here. It doesn't have to be perfect, it just has to look right. That's the trick to it. Okay. I'm going to do this in about three stages. A background wash, and I'll try to keep some of the white of the paper in critical places. And then once that is in, the main shapes are going to lay right over top of that. And that's the bones of the painting. That's the set. And then the actors go in last. Just figures, maybe a car, probably a car. keep track of that vanishing point, so these lines don't look like they're all going every which way. To always leave a little sparkle of light. You don't know where it's coming from, reflecting off of a roof of a car or something, but just it gives the wash a little bit of life. There's a little highlight here on the roof of the car. I could add it in later with white, but I like to keep it if I like to protect it if I can. Sometimes I lose it and you have to come back. But it's always nice if you can keep it the white of the paper, you know, the light of the paper. Cool this down a little bit, the building that's further back. Thank you.
It's just this idea of what's on the floor. So can you put it down a little bit? Yeah. Sounds a little too deific. So there's some buildings on the other side catching little glints of sunlight. I don't want to get detailed with them, I just want to suggest what's there. I like the details in the shadow to blur. So I try to put them into a slightly damp wash, and then details that are in highlight to be crisp, like that. But details on this side of the building, I want to put them in at just the right time, so that they're not too crisp. And they sort of, it feels to me when I look at a building like that, I look into the shadow, that the detail is not sharp. I think it's Forget that perspective point. These two brushes are almost the same, except this one holds a ton of water, and this one doesn't hold much water. So it's perfect for keeping details crisp, whereas this one can flood the paper and ruin and destroy your details. Make some people happen. Couldn't be New York without people. So in my drawing, I drew a streetlight pole with the lamp arcing over the top, and I think I don't like that in the composition. I'm going to turn it the other way. It's what I find the sketchbook also very useful for, besides working on a roadmap for a painting. I sometimes spot little things that I would consider to be an error. This is one of those, starts out as a paintbrush, ends up as a rigger.
Yeah.
Can't really make up its mind. It holds a little bit more paint.
I like it.
Is that what it's called?